This video will walk you through the disassembly and reassembly of the Microsoft Surface Pro 8 tablet. Before you begin, ensure that your work surface is covered with an EST-safe, non-marring material like this anti-static mat. Check that your surface is clean and clear of any debris or abrasive particles. Equip an anti-static wrist strap, ensure that your work area is properly grounded and safe, and lastly, make sure that you're wearing protective eyewear as a safety precaution. If you're performing a touch display module replacement, make sure to run the TDM pre-repair software preparation before you begin any disassembly. To begin, make sure that your device is powered off and disconnected from the power supply, and then place your device face down on the work surface. Raise your kickstand to about 90 degrees and locate the rSSD door on the back of the device. To access the rSSD, begin by inserting a SIM eject tool into the small hole on the door to eject it. Use a 3IP Torx Plus driver to remove the single screw securing the rSSD. When the screw is removed, the rSSD will pop up slightly. Gently grasp it by its sides and pull it out from its socket at about a 15 degree angle. Make sure to store the removed rSSD in a clean, ESD-safe area. While bracing the back of the kickstand with your hand, use your 3IP Torx Plus driver to remove the two hinge screws. While grasping both hinges, lower them to about 45 degrees, and then raise the kickstand about 10 degrees to free it from the threaded bosses on each hinge. Pull the kickstand out and away from the tablet at about a 55 degree angle, making sure the threaded bosses don't catch on the hinges during removal. If the tabs or pads show any sign they may have left pieces behind in the device, abort the repair. The whole unit must be exchanged. Do not attempt to retrieve stuck pieces through the slot. Flip your device over so the display is facing up, and then insert a plastic opening tool into the seam between the right speaker mesh and the edge of the device. Pull the opening tool towards the device to deform the speaker mesh and create a gap in the speaker mesh area. Slide the opening tool along the length of the speaker mesh area to push the speaker mesh under the touch display module. To remove the touch display module, we'll be using a debonding tool. To start, prepare an opening pick by measuring and marking a 2 and 8 mm depth on the opening pick. Use a 3 mm hex driver to raise the pick holder to its highest position, and then remove the pick holder and place your marked opening pick into it. Reinsert the pick holder into the top of the debonding tool, and then use your 3 mm hex driver to re-engage the attachment screw into the pick holder. Using two spring clamps, clamp the debonding tool to the edge of your workbench, making sure the adjustment screw can still be accessed. Place the right edge of the device into your debonding tool, and then use your 3 mm hex driver to adjust the pick height to the 2 mm mark on your pick. Lower the device's right speaker cutout onto the pick so that the tip slides behind the touch display module. Grasp the device with both hands, and then slowly slide the right edge through the debonding tool track until you reach the corner. Once you've reached the corner, rotate the device in the debonding tool track to slice around the corner. Continue sliding and rotating the device until you've sliced through the entire device perimeter, and then remove the device from the debonding tool. Using your 3 mm hex driver, adjust the opening pick height to your 8 mm mark, and then slowly lower the device's top left edge onto the pick so that the tip slides behind the touch display module. Grasp the device with both hands, and then slide the device along the debonding tool track. Lift the left, right, and top edges slightly, and use a pick to slice through any remaining strands of adhesive. Flip the touch display module over and set it face down on the device, making sure not to strain the attached cable or touch the exposed battery. Insert the point of a pair of tweezers underneath the clip on the front corner of the touch display module FPC shield. Repeat this procedure on the other front corner of the shield, and then lift the shield up and off. Insert the point of a spudger under one side of the touch display module FPC connector and pry it up to loosen it, and then insert it into the other side to pry it up and fully disconnect it. remove the touch display module and place it into a soft ESD safe location. Locate the fan ZIF connector on the device and use the point of a spudger to flip up the locking bar. With your tweezers, grasp the fan cable and then slide the cable out of the ZIF connector. Use your 3IP Torx Plus driver to remove the 12 screws securing the thermal module. Make sure to note the LTE and Wi-Fi models of this device have slightly different screw sizes and positioning. Use the flat end of a spudger to pry up and loosen the edge of the thermal module copper shield. Grab the thermal shield from the center of the shield or the fan and carefully lift it away from the device. Use your spudger to scrape off the residual thermal paste from the system on chip area, and then use some isopropyl alcohol and a lint-free cloth to remove any remaining thermal paste. Check to see if the speaker cable has disconnected during thermal module removal. If it has, make sure to fully reconnect it and make sure it's properly routed before reassembly. Remove the heat spreader tape covering the Surflink cable, and then using the flat edge of your spudger, flip up the Surflink PCBA connector cover. Using the point of your spudger, push the edges of the PCBA connector out of its socket. Use a 6IP Torx Plus driver to remove the two screws securing the Surflink connector, and then remove the Surflink assembly. To reinstall the Surflink assembly, begin by using your 6IP Torx driver to install two new screws to secure the Surflink connector. Slide the cable connector into its socket on the motherboard. Use your finger or the flat edge of a spudger to flip down the PCBA connector cover, and then reinstall new heat spreader tape. To reinstall the thermal module, begin by replacing the spring gasket. Use your fingers to press the gasket into place, and then ensure that it's fully seated along its perimeter. Set the replacement thermal module into place over the device, aligning the copper shield over the spring gasket. Press down along the perimeter of the shield to snap it into place over the spring gasket. Reinstall the 12 screws securing the thermal module. If you're working with an LTE module, make sure that the foam blocks are present in these locations. If any are missing, replace them. Locate the fan ZIF connector and use your tweezers to insert the fan's cable. Lock the cable by using your spudger to press down the locking bar on the connector. Use tweezers or an opening tool to remove any remaining adhesive and speaker mesh remnants from the device. Once you've removed all the adhesive, clean the surface with some isopropyl alcohol and a lint-free cloth. If you're reinstalling the same touch display module, remove all the adhesive from the edges of the device and clean it with some isopropyl alcohol and a lint-free cloth. Peel the clear protective liner from the replacement speaker mesh back and remove a speaker mesh and handle. Remove its blue liner and then orient the speaker mesh so that the exposed adhesive is face down. Press it into place, and then use the side of your tweezers to press down on the mesh for 10 seconds, allowing the adhesive to activate. Repeat this process on the other side. Flip the display module over to verify that the meshes are aligned properly. Lay out your replacement adhesive strips with the blue liner facing up, making sure the adhesive follows the outline of the case. Peel the clear aligner from the adhesive strip, and then use your fingers to press it into place. Place the touch display module face down over the device, and align the cable connector over its motherboard socket. Press the cable connector down on one side, and then the other to fully seat it in place. Reinstall a new FP shield over the cable connector and press down on both sides to lock it in place. Peel the blue liners from all four adhesive strips. Align the touch display module to the top edge of the device and then lower it into place. Ensure that the glass sits flush and the display is not resting anywhere on the top of the lip. Place a bonding frame over the touch display module, making sure the cutouts align with the buttons. And then place a foam pad and a 50-pound evenly distributed weight on top. Leave the weight on top for at least 1 minute to bond to the adhesive. Once bonded, remove the weight, foam, and bonding frame, and inspect the touch display module for scratches, cracks, or gaps. Flip the device over and position the hinges at about a 45 degree angle, and then gently slide the kickstand tabs about 3/4 of the way into their slots. Tilt the kickstand slightly to position the kickstand recesses into the outer lip of the hinge. Both hinges should sit flush with the kickstand. Tilt the kickstand down slightly to fully seat the threaded bosses into place and fully insert the tabs. Grasp both hinges and raise them to about 90 degrees. Apply some Loctite activator to a new hinge screw and a drop of thread locker to its screw hole, and then use your 3IP Torx Plus driver to reinstall new hinge screws. Fold the kickstand down, remove any plastic from the kickstand if present, and then verify that its edges line up with the case and there are no obvious gaps. Raise the kickstand back up to about a 90 degree angle, and then slide the rSSD into its socket. Install a new 3IP Torx Plus screw to secure the rSSD. Align the top edge of the rSSD door to the recess, and then gradually push it down to latch it into place. Wipe down the device thoroughly with a microfiber cloth to remove any dust or fingerprints. With the tablet reassembled, run the appropriate post-repair software verification and software calibration to finish the repair.